After the roaring success of its previous edition, the Hero Campus Challenge was back in its fifth season, organized by the country's largest two-wheeler maker, Hero MotoCorp. The Hero Campus Challenge is a unique initiative that aims to nurture future business leaders. Launched in 2015, the Hero Campus Challenge is a business solutions-oriented competition where students from prestigious B-schools and engineering colleges compete to find innovative solutions to real-world business and technology challenges. With two-wheeler mobility as the overarching theme, the B-school contestants were tasked to offer digital solutions to enhance customer experience, and the contestants from engineering colleges were challenged to create products and design solutions leveraging artificial intelligence and cutting-edge technology to meet the evolving needs of customers. This year, over 32,000 students registered for the competition, forming nearly 11,000 teams from both B-schools and engineering colleges. The top 10 teams made it through to the finale, where they presented their ideas to a distinguished jury panel comprising academicians and senior officials of Hero MotoCorp.
This year, as a team, we said, let's have season 5 more grander, more better than ever, more exciting, and of course, setting new benchmarks. And look at it here. On D-Day, we have a stellar audience. We have the best of B-schools and E-schools with us. And of course, thanks to our jury members and leadership members who are there to support us. So our heartfelt gratitude to all of you that we have made that achieve. Today is the day, and of course, may the best team win. So good luck to you all. Rise up to the challenge, and Godspeed.
The challenge flagged off with a lamp lighting ceremony and was followed by the opening remarks by Vijay Sethi, the Chief HR and Information Officer and Head of CSR at Hero MotoCorp, who recounted the journey of the Hero Campus Challenge.
So we did an outreach to various institutes, various colleges, more than 540,000 students. So there's a view, whatever we did on social media, so there's more than 550,000 views that happened. So we went to our students who registered. More than 32,000 students registered. In fact, that's a fantastic number, which really, if we see from last year, it has grown multifold. Each team of 3 students registered into a team. So we had more than 10,000 teams this time. As we move forward, we did an offline assessment round. I think roughly around 7,000, yeah, 6,900 teams participated. Moved on to the next round, which is the elevator pitch, idea elevator pitch, again, more than 1,000 odd teams, fantastic numbers. So that shows that Hero Campus Challenge in its season 5 has really gone to a very different level. We had a virtual round presentation, 80 odd teams, and today we have the top 10 teams who are there for our grand final. So really come through this grind, and I must congratulate you. So last year it was a good show. I'm sure even the quality of presentations this year would be even much better. It was, I won't say that the last year's presentations were bad. They were fantastic. But what I expect from each one of you is even much better. Thanks to jury members. Some of the jury members were there last year, I know. So thanks to you.
Soon it was time for the 5 teams from prestigious B-schools to gear up and pitch their unique ideas to the jury in the B-school track of the competition. The jury for the B-school track comprised Harsh V. Verma, Professor of Marketing and Strategy at Faculty of Management Studies, Delhi University. Rohit Mehtani, Professor of International Business at Indian Institute of Foreign Trade, New Delhi. Jaskiran Arora, Professor of Accounting and Finance at BML Munjal University, Gurugram. Sanjay Tripathi, Associate Vice President of Sales and Marketing at Hero MotoCorp. Sanjay Seth, Head of Taxation and Finance at Hero MotoCorp. And Saurabh Prakash, Senior General Manager at the CEO's Office at Hero MotoCorp. The first team to present their idea was Team Kathor from IIM Rohtak.
Given a case to suggest an idea in the two-wheeler shared mobility segment for Hero And to come up with that, first we identified three major problems, which were there are people who do not have enough money to purchase a two-wheeler. Secondly, there are people who are confused about which model to buy. And thirdly, there are people who think they cannot take the risk of purchasing an electric vehicle. So to solve all these problems, we came up with Hero Moka. Hero Moka is a subscription-based service where people can subscribe to a bike of their choice for different time periods and can eventually purchase it if they are satisfied with it.
Now, coming to the market opportunities, we can see in macroeconomic factors, the youth bulge has already started in India, and also government initiative to push the sales in automobile sector, especially the electric vehicles. From McKinsey report, it is feasible that in US and UK, around 10% of the overall sales of in automobile sector will be through subscription-based model by 2026. And also in 2019, the global fleet size of the rental companies have doubled. Further, we will explain by Nikhil.
So, we have conducted a primary research to understand the opinion of our customers and Hero dealership owners. And we found out that all the dealers were interested in this service and ready to offer a subscription-based model from their dealerships. Further, we also interacted with the banks and NBFCs and insurance partners available at dealership, and they were willing to partner with us for this service. Service centers appeared willing to for the servicing and maintenance of bikes and were ready to return these bikes within the 24 hours. We have interacted with more than 100 people through surveys selected on the basis of a convenience-based sampling, and we found out that a majority number of two-wheeler users face a dilemma while choosing a particular bike model, so they can offer this service.
Primarily, what you said in your presentation was that, well, you're offering this service to those people who have dilemma whether to own a bike or to rent a bike. You said your subscription charge is 2,800 something. Now, in Indian scenario, what are the connotations of ownership?
First of all, I would like to clarify that what we found out that the dilemma is not in between owning and renting a bike. But while a person is purchasing two-wheeler, he faces a dilemma between different models. Many of them also reported that after using a bike for a certain period, they felt that they might have chosen this second model.
Sorry to cut you. So you are solving that dilemma through service. So I have a problem with selection of bike.
Yes. Yeah,
so and your service is coming to rescue me.
Yeah.
On that, so I will change my model to subscription.
No, a person can actually use a bike for some time, maybe a 6 months or so, and if they are liking that particular bike, they can retain it by purchasing it at the price of which is on that particular day. Secondly, if they are not satisfied with that bike and if they want to try another bike, they can do that by this model.
Second in line was Team Dazzle from Narsi Munji Institute of Management Studies, Mumbai.
India is at an inflection in development of its mobility solutions. We created this model to leverage this opportunity and provide last mile connectivity and mobility freedom to the consumers.
So here we present Hero Honeycomb Mobility, a hotspot and shared spaces model. Let's see how it works. A person gets down at a public transport station and reaches a hotspot present there. Now this hotspot, it is a leased land at public transport stations and regular commute places like corporate hubs and institutes. So he scans the QR code of the bike and he unlocks the scooter. Fingerprint scanning starts the scooter, and now he reaches the destination where he parks his vehicle at a shared space of his corporate hub. Now these shared spaces or park spaces are leveraged through public and private parkings by having tie-ups with them. Also, these shared spaces are connected to a hotspot in a centralized manner. So this model is as simple for the customer as it looks like.
Coming on to the technological interventions, we first talked about existing technologies like tire locks with alarm system, fingerprint sensors, and GPS trackers that have been leveraged as shown here in various stages of our operations. Coming on addressing the anti-theft scenarios, we talk about three proposed technologies to address the same. Our first technology is a USB and a primary differentiator, which is a GSM SIM-based anti-theft device. This fits right inside the handle of a scooter, making it invisible to the naked eye. Our next solution is a smart helmet. This helmet has a tracking device to prevent theft, has crash detector in cases of accidents, and a Bluetooth earpiece for safe calling. Our last solution is a live camera, which will fit right inside the dashboard of your scooter. What it does is it provides a timely video feed and at the same time reduces liability in cases of accidents.
You have said that the two-wheelers which are lying idle, you know, will be used for this purpose. So, in case of people who use these two-wheelers roughly, or if there is an accident, you know, misuse of the two-wheelers, how do you take care, and how is the guy who's giving out his two-wheeler for renting purpose or for this subscription purpose, how is he going to get compensated?
We talked about our technology interventions which we have seen here, and at the same time, this is one thing which we did not put in here, is periodic. So we leverage Hero dealership, and we take in the servicemen which will periodically check the bikes after, let's say, a couple of days or something, and they will go to these shared spaces and the technology and the hotspots to see if the working condition is proper or not. Obviously, and to add to that, there will be a regular servicing of these bikes, also of the bikes which have been serviced by the people to our model, which will make sure that the condition when they return that is absolutely the same which we had put in across.
Next up, we're seeing four visionaries from Ford School of Management, Delhi.
So talking about our idea, it takes into consideration two stakeholders. On one side, we have the leasers, those who want to earn money by leasing their two-wheelers. And on the other side, we have the renters, those who want to rent two-wheelers for commuting-related purposes. Now, we wish to bring the two together on board through our common platform. And we wish to ensure the security of two-wheelers through telematics and digital locks, as well as we will ensure all the legal compliances. So moving on, why would anybody want to rent a two-wheeler in the first place? So these are the three need gaps that we have identified based on our primary research. Number one being the inconvenient and the time-consuming public transport, the high cost of ownership of personal vehicles, and the huge amount of traffic jams on the metro city roads. So these are the problems that we are trying to solve through our two-wheeler, peer-to-peer two-wheeler sharing.
Now, another question is, who will be our target customer? So for our P2P shared mobility, we would be targeting Gen Z and Gen Y, the people who lie in the age gap between 22 to 45. Now, in this generation, we would be targeting A3, B1, B2, C1, C2 socioeconomic classes. This would be further bifurcated into two categories, that is working professional and students, who are migrating from their hometown to the metropolitan cities. Last but not least, last mile delivery. By catering this segment, we would ensure B2B services with B2C. Now over to Karan.
So currently, as of now, we are in the ideation stage and expected to reach into execution by 2021. Now quickly taking you through the wireframe of our application, which we are going to provide to the end users. So we can clearly see from renting or leasing a vehicle to locating their vehicle on the Google Map, everything has been designed while keeping ease of use and user experience in mind. Also note that dedicated space has been given to user persona so that it would create a sense of transparency in the minds of both stakeholders, that the other person I'm renting my bike to, and through the driving score and other habits like how the person drives and purpose a person is using our vehicles for driving.
For your target group, what are the alternatives that they have, and how does your model offer sustainability and green environment?
The alternatives have been discussed in the appendix slide. So for example, they have the public transport. These are some of the public transport, for example, taxi and auto. They are definitely more costlier than our model. Talking about the buses, which are definitely cheaper, but they are very time-consuming, congested, and inconvenient.
So if these are the alternatives, then how is your model making it more greener? The vehicles on the road would rather increase, right? Or the fuel consumption would rather increase. How will your model add or contribute to green environment?
No, we aren't talking about greener environment. We only said that ours will be reducing the congestion, and it will increase the profitability as well as leverage the boom.
It's a pretty exhaustive process and pretty thought-through process. And it brings out key thoughts, key learnings, and probably ideas which can be implemented in the future. We don't know whether we are seeing a next startup from here.
I could make out that generations have moved, maybe two generations have moved. And their thinking capacity, everything is very innovative, very techy. What we talk about, just generation next or the generation connect, I could feel it today.
The Hero Campus Challenge,
provides an opportunity to the best and brightest minds to showcase their talent and business skills by solving real-life business challenges targeted towards Hero MotoCorp's mammoth consumer base. Following the teams from Rohtak, Mumbai and Delhi respectively, it was time for the fourth team, Team Kingpins from Symbiosis Center for Management and Human Resource Development, Pune, to present their idea.
If you look at the current available commute options of public, in that people have to switch from one mode of transport to another mode of transport, which result in higher cost and inconvenience cost. So, we solve this problem by our unique hybrid free phone model. Let us understand this model through a customer journey. Take for example one of our customer Ritik, who want to reach his office. In this case, his home is 1 kilometer away from our docking station. So, we are providing him an option of bicycle to reach our station. Once he reaches our station, he unlocks and uses the bike to reach a dock which is near to his office. And then again, if needed, depending on the distance, he has an option to use bicycle to reach his final destination, that is office. So, in this way, we have created a complete ecosystem by providing both the option of free phone model and docking station model. If you talk about the advantage to Hero, one of the key advantages is that it will help to increase positive word of mouth and awareness of its newly launched electrical vehicle, because we will be using purely electrical vehicle in our system.
Now coming to our first big idea, that is two-wheeler full share service. In this, we are providing platform for non-riders to be a part of shared mobility network. Now, in starting, the users can request for shared ride using our on-the-spot or advanced booking option. Once they request for ride, we will connect rider and pillion using our algorithm. Now, after they accept the ride, they can unlock vehicle and helmets using QR code scanner. After reaching their destination, they can end ride and review each other for future customer references.
As a part of competitive analysis with our top 4 competitors, we have asked people to rate our model and other model on the basis of affordability, safety, smart features, services and convenience. We have been ranked either first or equally to the other competitors. We have also the point of difference of our model is that we are more environment friendly, more affordable and more safer. Also, we are including non-rider in our services.
How's your proposal different from, you know, if we have Ola two-wheeler cabs? How will you differentiate this with that? And how will you ensure the safety, what, you know, Professor Verma is asking? Yeah.
Comparing to the Ola, Ola is a driver-based model. Our model is driverless model. And also we are providing a complete ecosystem by providing first mile and last mile connectivity. So current competitor is Vogo and providing dock to dock station. So user have to reach their dock using a cab, which is again costly. So we are providing an option of bicycle if our dock is away, like 1 kilometer away from his home. So you can use a bicycle, 3-4 model of bicycle, and again, once he comes to a dock, he uses our e-bikes to travel from another dock, final destination. And again, if needed, if his final destination is 1 kilometer away from a dock, so he can also use a bicycle to reach his office.
Raring to prove their mettle in the competition, Team Sylvester from XLRI Jamshedpur took to the stage to present the fifth and final B-School presentation.
So this is our product, Wave, which is a pay-as-you-go self-driven two-wheeler rental service. Now we are providing you two different options, which is a pick and drop point as well as a wave option. So pick and drop points, you can essentially walk into one of our points, pick up a vehicle and be on your way, or you can also have a share-based service where you can have you can wait for a driver and then act as a rider. Secondly, you have Wave coming in where the customer would be matched with the rider who would be going the same way, and the location of both the rider as well as the co-rider is going to be provided to both the co-riders. And the prices would be varying in accordance with the distance that you will be traveling as well as the distance you will be traveling on a shared basis. And this is how it works. So the first step is identification of location. Second up, you have moving to either the nearest pick and drop point or you have the Wave option. Third up is the rates which are going to be displayed in accordance with the services that you will be taking up. And fourth, we'll be matching you to the riders as well as whether you'll be using a pick and drop point.
Right. So now we try to answer a few internal questions and understand our product better. Firstly, what is the source of our bikes? We made two different models. Firstly, using only Hero bikes, and secondly, a model like the Olas and the Ubers do, where they crowdsource the bikes. We found that profitability was maximum when we used only Hero bikes, and that has been reflected in our financial model. We have put two designated personnel at each pick and drop point who ensure that refueling is done, repair is done, cash is collected in that case. We found that there are legal hassles as well as damage to the vehicle which has to be dealt with. So we've bought insurance and insured yellow plates which have also been accounted for in our financial model.
So these are the costs. After a very thorough analysis of the value chain, we have classified them into the following categories. And all of these costs consist of a number of sub-costs which have been calculated after taking the current inflation rates, the upcoming BS6 norms, and a number of other considerations that we felt could affect our costs. And as can be seen, we're charging a lower price from customers who go on a shared basis, and in that even lower from the drivers to incentivize them to drive. On the basis of this calculation, these are the profits that we've computed, and as can be seen, we'll be reaching a break-even point in a period less than 3 years. And in just a matter of 5 years, we'll be able to reach a net profit margin of 16%, which is in line with Hero's current EBITDA margin of 14.65%.
During the course of your presentation, you made a statement that this model is going to work better with Hero bikes. What made you say that?
So because we essentially found that we talked to a lot of people, including dealers and users of bikes, and they said that almost no sale happens if there are no test rides. Now, because ours is a self-driven service, so essentially you will be driving the bike by yourself, and you know that these are Hero bikes, because our only source of bikes are Hero, right? So if Heroes or if any motorbike suppliers or sellers' main idea is to give that test ride to a customer, to convert him to a potential customer to an actual sale, then that endpoint of sale is happening with us.
And with the last presentation, the B2 track of the competition came to an end. All 5 teams successfully presented their ideas to the jury, giving them ample food for thought in selecting a winner.
The idea that they had to work on seems to be very relevant, very contemporary, and we had the opportunity of looking at some of the very interesting presentations made by the students. So in that sense, it was a very useful exercise, you know, done by the Hero MotoCorp.
Most of the participants, they were right in the first year. So in the first year, the kind of vibrancy, the expression that they have, and most of all, couple of groups are very witty. So I think that is what the need of the hour is, and they displayed amazing skills and attitude.
So the entire objective of the presentations and all this was to get some ideas about hassle-free, end-to-end, cheap mobility solutions. And the presentation which happened, the students worked very hard towards that, and some of them were able to give some valuable suggestions to achieve the target.
Hero Campus Challenge has evolved into a prestigious platform that nurtures innovation and business acumen of the best young minds from India's leading business and engineering schools. After the B-School competition, it was time for the engineering track of the Campus Challenge, where D-School students locked horns. The jury of the E-School comprised H.P. Gupta, Senior General Manager of Finance at Hero MotoCorp; Avinash Joshi, Senior General Manager of Plant Operations Gurugram at Hero MotoCorp; Piyush Kumar, Senior General Manager of Plant Operations Dharueda at Hero MotoCorp; Anil Singh Parihar, Professor of Computer Science at Delhi Technological University; and Saurav Hussain, Professor of Computer Science and Engineering at BML Munjal University, Gurugram. The first team to take the stage was Team Urja, from Netaji Subhas University of Technology, Delhi.
According to a study by the Harvard Business Review, in which they surveyed approximately 15,000 companies, it was found that the more collaborative the machines and the humans are working, the better is the output. Now coming to the idea, that is AI-assisted human activity recognition for training of technicians. So what are we planning to do here? As you can see in the video, there is a technician working, and AI predicts what he is doing. In this video, he is pushing. So AI will label the task as push, and finally when he is waiting, the AI will say that the activity is wait. So in this way, we can teach, train the workers or the technicians working at the Hero MotoCorp.
Thank you, Utkarsh. Now let's move forward to the next idea, that is about the environment. Can you see India is red in both the maps? India is red because most of the 11 out of 12 most polluted cities in the world are in India. Second, 12.5% of the cause of death is air pollution. Now, this is the problem. What is the solution? Now, let me tell you. ELVs, end-of-life vehicles, is one of the solutions that we can propose. These are the total counts. Out of 100%, 77% of the ELVs is two-wheelers. Now, how ELV will be processed? Depollution, dismantling, and shredder. We'll use artificial intelligence's dismantling. These are the parts which can be separated in the dismantling, like fuel tanks, seats, shock absorbers, mirrors, etc. In this process, we'll consider two parameters, the mass and the similarity index. The mass is because after age, the mass gets degraded of a vehicle. And similarity index is the image processing part. Image processing, how we'll do this? Image processing, we'll use the data set of the images of the parts as inputs. And after that, we'll train the neural network, convolutional neural network, to give us the image of the part to be segregated. The output will be the similarity index. Like if it is 0.1, it is a bad image. And if it is 0.9, means it is a good class of image. So the 0.9 will tell us that this part can be reused and recycled again. This is the cost-benefit analysis that I've done. The benefit-to-cost ratio comes with the use of artificial intelligence is 1.34. And now India is moving towards ULB. This is the need of ours. So let's be the first to set an example to use artificial intelligence to save our environment. And I know Hero can do this.
So let's say your task of collecting data is solved, right? This problem is solved. What about these models? How does this concept of LSTM fit here? And why do you think that convolutional neural network can actually help you in that waste management? Because there is no mapping, right? There should be something technical in your talk.
Sir, in waste management, what I was saying that when a part comes, then we'll have compare two parameters. We'll formulate a formula, means W1 into the recyclability rate plus W2 into the similarity index. Now, the recyclability rate is the...
How did you get to this formula?
Sir, that I am suggesting right now. Because I was thinking ki, we'll set the weights according to ourselves. Because, see, if there is a mirror... Okay, so if it is broken, the mass will not change, but the similarity index will change on the basis of image image segregation. The image will be compared and it will give you 0.1 similarity index.
Team Legacy Leavers from NIT Raipur were next to present their idea.
You must be thinking, what does Shunya represent? That's what our target is. To reduce these problems to zero, we focus on achieving Shunya Death and Shunya Theft. To achieve this, we come up with an idea which will consist of two phases. The first one is security, which ignites the engine only after authenticating the user, thereby preventing any unauthorized access. For a safety concern, we ignite the engine only after ensuring that the rider is wearing a helmet.
So this is the flowchart of our idea. Here, the user first turns the electric button on. For authentication, if the user is admin, face recognition is used. Otherwise, passcode key verification will be used. It then checks whether the user is wearing helmet or not. Only after satisfying both the conditions, the user will be able to ignite the engine. Our idea uses Bluetooth module, keypad, Arduino Uno, mobile phone, NRF trans receiver, and a capacitive touch sensor for making bike and helmet module.
With our analysis, we came up with these factors that might be the reason behind it. First is the technology issue. Second is cost, and third is adoption.
We have come up with a solution for these problems. First, technology. With the advancement of technologies, now smaller modules can be made that can be easily fitted in the bike as we have done in our idea. Second is cost. We have also thought of a solution to reduce cost, and if the cost is reduced, adoption to new changes will automatically increase. Our module will cost around 3500 rupees. Considering that it will be bought in bulk, it will cost around 30% to Hero. considering 20% as manufacturing cost, 5% as logistic cost, and 18% GST, it will cost around 3600 to a customer.
As discussed, the total cost of our model was 3600, from which we are considering 1500 from government, 700 from the insurance company, and 700 from the customer, making a total of 2900. The rest 700 would be taken care by Hero MotoCorp Limited.
So your model does not take care of the road accident or third party insurance, right?
Yes, sir.
So how can you assume that 700 will come from that coffer?
We are, our idea talks about protecting the bike, like theft, anti-theft. We are working on something that the bike does not get lost or get theft. So if the reduction in that portion comes, so we feel that an insurance company will have more margin. The insurance company will not have to give back more money on them, on the person who is a victim or has lost his bike or whose bike has been theft.
Sir, we can actually create a number of class depending on the number of users we have in the family, and we do consider that situation, and we have thought of a model like in the app. Only I have registered myself because I have only made the class for myself, but this can be extended to the number of family members in the family. I can train the model and it can be implemented.
The third team competing in the challenge was Team Jala the Hut from IIT Madras.
Presenting Hero Sathi, our answer to the future of bike maintenance. Now, historically, vehicular maintenance has been addressed in multiple different ways. For example, reactive maintenance is one in which the bike is serviced once the failure has already been reached. Then we moved on to preventive maintenance, where the bike is periodically serviced, but this leads to a lot of overhead maintenance costs. The issues with reactive maintenance, which is high unplanned downtime and the overhead in the maintenance costs, are addressed in predictive maintenance, where we mount sensors on the bike to intelligently monitor the bike's health on a real-time basis and provide suggestions to the user to take his or her bike to the service center to get the part serviced before failure has been reached. Now, predictive maintenance has certain advantages which make it the prime choice. From a PwC report, it says that predictive maintenance improves fuel efficiency, reduces downtime, improves the rider's safety, and an overall extension in the lifespan of the vehicle. Now, over to Hero Sathi, which is our solution.
So coming to the tech aspect of it, let's move on to data collection. So we have two sources of data collection. The first is on the bike itself, where we have sensors mounted on the bike and we collect data from that. The second is on the Hero service centers, where we get information such as which bike has come in, when it's come in, for what issue it's come in, and what is the criticality of this issue. So the data we get from the service center serves as a label for the data we get from the sensors.
So we basically did a guesstimate approach by dividing the entire module into hardware and software and figured out that it would cost about 2,500 for us to develop the Hero Sathi module. Now, any solution has to be validated in the wild, and we did just that in the two-pronged strategy by doing a rigorous survey and visits to dealerships across Chennai. And what is interesting to note is that the demographic was primarily 80% of them were under the age of 30, which is Hero's primary target audience for the future. And it is very encouraging to note that the overall market sentiment was positive, even when we stressed the higher upfront cost, because the markets saw value in this solution.
Look into a kind of an maybe versions, various versions of your solutions, maybe a low-cost version for the entry-level bike, and maybe typically this full-fledged version for the high-end bikes, something of that kind, you have to think. So bring out various options for a OEM to think about this idea to implement practically. Okay?
So just a small reply to that. So yes, sir, we have considered that, and the 2,500 rupee cost is basically what it took for us to make that module. And obviously we know of Hero's high standards in manufacturing, and we feel that this cost can definitely be decreased when we are operating at scale. So this cost can definitely be reduced. And also this entire cost needn't to be transferred to the customer because we operate in a very price sensitive market. So instead of transferring to the customer, since we're getting all this data, the data is equal to money going forward, and we think this can be offset in the future.
And I thought a lot of work has gone into this and a lot of creativity, you know, our students have shown. And it's a very enriching experience today that we came across in a business school and engineering school.
both of them brought different perspective which we can use moving forward.
This is the thing that normally student is looking for. This is kind of very good opportunity given by industry, because otherwise they are involved in many subjects and written exams and maybe some projects. But these projects actually give them real life examples, and they have to solve the problem from end to end basis. I mean, from real life problem they are thinking as an engineer and how to handle it. That gives a lot of exposure to them.
Season 5 of Hero Campus Challenge turned out to be a challenging yet enriching experience, not just for the participants but for the jury as well. And in a bid to win the coveted title, it was time for the fourth team in the engineering track of the Campus Challenge, Team Phoenix from Mid Mitra, to present its idea.
We all know that smartphones are actually very much common. And it is smart because it is not just about calling features, but it can do much more than it. Then why don't our vehicle become smart too? This problem has been dealt by the automobile industries, and Hero MotoCorp, being the pioneer of bringing in advanced technologies, is ought to bring in artificial intelligence into the vehicles. The attack strategy that we are proposing is improve the program fuel injection using AI and introduction of electric vehicles. And the reinforcement strategy that we are proposing is train the employees in artificial intelligence to avoid the step down in market competition. For doing this, the idea that we are proposing is intelligent driving vehicle, which comprises of prediction of driving anomalies and reckless driving, a vehicle diagnostic system, and improved programmed fuel injection using AI, and a vehicle stability control.
Now let's take a look at the benefits of our model. Our model helps to recognize reckless driving in real time with the help of a check light. Second, vehicular diagnostics help in inventory control at the service stations. Third, the data can be utilized by the company to make improvements in their present vehicles. Fourth, the data can also be utilized by the driver to figure out better ways of driving. And lastly, improvement in programmed fuel injection helps in improving fuel efficiency of the vehicle. Our model also helps Hero to move towards a clean and better future. By replacing the faulty sensors, we reduce the emission of gases, and by improving the fuel efficiency, we reduce the emission of gases like CO and NOx.
Speaking of clean environment, what's better than electric vehicles? Electric vehicles are the future, and so is AI. So why don't we integrate the both? Well, we have proposed two models. The first is for range anxiety, and the other is for improving the vehicle stability using AI in electric vehicles. Hero has three major principles: customer care, environmental safety, and new and intelligent advancements. And our models align with all of these three principles.
More point that you are saying that reckless driving, etc., will be noted and data will be uploaded on some server. Why do you feel that, as a driver, why should I do that? Why should I, get my data uploaded and then getting difficulty in insurance, etc., everything?
So that's a very good question, sir, because many of the drivers don't desire to leak the data. That's what we actually have mentioned over there, that from the onboard diagnostic system, the data is sent to the phone via Bluetooth, and Bluetooth can only work when the driver is willing to send his data. So it's dependent on the driver that if he has to do, and for the proper working of the vehicle, if he wills to get the proper working of the vehicle for a longevity of the vehicle, he has to have to do that.
The engineering track came to a close with a presentation by Team Crankers from Sri Vishnu Engineering College for Women, Andhra Pradesh.
It was raining heavily. The headlights of other vehicles were striking my eyes too badly that I couldn't see the roads. And the worst part was that the roads were filled with water, where I can't find where the road is and where the dicks are. In this scenario, people in drunken state were driving too rashly that I can't believe myself that I can go home safely. So, we have made a mind that it was a rare nightmare for me. We formed Team Crankers. We discovered to crank up safer lives from Sri Vishnu Engineering College for Women, Bhimavaram. Our mission is to develop a smart and a safe hero for a real hero, where the vision to expand the artificial intelligence without the unemployment and to implement the facilities to be one of its kind in the two-wheelers. So, we are using artificial intelligence for the safety check and also for the accident prevention. And again, the safety check goes with the bike theft, bike and driver basic check. And the accident prevention deals with the two important things, the bumper droop detector and also with the headlight intensity modulator. As nothing comes easy and nothing comes for free. So, this is the cost estimation of a case one. And the cost required for this is 3,195 rupees.
If you shut your eyes for a few minutes, it would be too late. Same thing happens when the headlight intensity strikes on your eyes. For this, we had a solution, that automatic headlight intensity modulator, in which we need few requirements like LDR sensor and microcontroller, which is easy in assembly and does not affect the aesthetics of the vehicle. And this is the circuit diagram. Coming to the working model, we used microcontroller as Arduino Uno. When the headlight of high intensity strikes on the LDR sensor, it gives to the microcontroller and reads the intensity of the light, and it modulates and gives the output. And the cost estimation, the minimum cost which we estimated is ₹465 without GST. And coming to the pros and cons, pros are more interesting so that cons can be neglected.
When you can see, road condition, why you need sensors? Why
yeah,
you need sensors?
Yeah, as I have explained.
Can be feel without sensors?
Firstly, sir, we can see the...
It's my prediction. It's when you are facing that bad road, then only you come to know that this is the bad road.
Yeah, we want to implement these cases. We thought to implement these cases, but in villages and the rural areas, at the night times, we can't able to see the speed records or the bumps. So we thought to implement these ideas.
The presentations were really amazing, whether it is B school or particularly what we evaluated the e-school presentations. Ideas were really great. Some of the ideas were amazing, and the efforts put by the students were visible into it.
So it's an excellent platform. I think it gives another, edge to the students, those who have presented, to get, I think, to put their ideas and to get the, the good interaction with the sound professionals.
The fifth season of Hero Campus Challenge culminated with a glittering prize ceremony, where the winning team were rewarded the prize money of ₹2 lakh, and the runners-up received the prize money of ₹1 lakh, in addition to pre-placement interviews at Hero MotoCorp. The runner-up in the engineering track of the challenge was Team Rankers from Sri Vishnu Engineering College for Women, Andhra Pradesh. The runner-up in the peaceful track of the challenge was Team Kapoor from IIM Rotak. The winner in the engineering track of the 5th edition of the Hero Campus Challenge was announced with great fanfare, with Team Java, the Hut from IIT Madras, taking home the laurels. Team Sylvester from XLRI Jamshedpur was adjudged the winner of the peaceful track of the Hero Campus Challenge.
When we started, small, but this year was a fantastic year. Over the last 5 years, we've been growing like anything. This year we had more than 32,000 registrations, more than 10,000 teams, which even till last year we were not expecting that. So it's a huge thing at the campus. And when we look at these ideas, they're fantastic ideas. The kids over there in engineering colleges and at business schools are fantastic.
I think the Hero Campus Challenge was designed in such a way that at each stage we had to incrementally build on an original idea, and putting in consistent efforts throughout got us here, and we are proud of that.
When we started out, the idea was probably something altogether different mm-hmm. from what it is now. So it's been a lot of grooming of the idea, pivoting, and that's something that the competition itself has allowed us to do.